So we already know how the coreboot build system looks like and what is built during the coreboot build process. However, we don't know yet what exactly is building our coreboot. So coreboot toolchain is necessary to build the coreboot binary image. This toolchain consists of compilers, bin utilities, package, ncurses, dev, libs, and ACPI compiler. So basically the compiler is compiling our code. The bin utilities contains the linker, which links the whole compiled objects by GCC into a single executable. Lib and curses are mainly used to display the configuration menu, which is used to create the text UI, and it's also used in the lib payload. The ACPI source code compiler is used to compile ACPI tables and code which is included in the coreboot source tree. Why do we even need the toolchain? Well, building a coreboot image is one thing, but one should note that coreboot supports multiple architectures, so we need a different toolchain for each architecture. So if we want to build for a given target architecture, cross-compilation may be often necessary. We also would like to avoid incompatibility issues due to some compiler setup. Also, compilers shipped with many distributions may not be compatible to perform a coreboot build. We all use the same build environment, then so it should be easier to set up and resolve potential issues. So how to build the coreboot toolchain? In order to build all available toolchains, we can use a make cross GCC command to build all in one shot. You can also build a specific toolchain. We have to just specify the target architecture in make cross GCC dash the arc. So usually it is enough to build this one since we are mainly going to be building, for example, for x86. So I would not recommend building the coreboot toolchain because it is very time consuming and is often error prone. We recommend to use the Docker container. If you decide to build the toolchain manually, after the build process it can be found at utils cross gcc xgcc slash bin directory. You will see that some of the tools that are part of the toolchain on this slide, but in fact the list is much longer. Inside the Docker, you might find it in opt xgcc bin. There will be lots of files for various architectures. So let's check out how does it look like. I am inside of the Docker already. So let's check how it looks like. As you can see, there is a toolchain for 64-bit architecture on x86. We have 64-bit RISC-V, 64-bit PowerPC, NDS, LLVM, and 32-bit x86 architecture. Also, CLang, ARM, and ARM 64-bit. As I have said earlier, sometimes the cross-compilation of the coreboot toolchain may be necessary. But how to tell coreboot where the toolchain is and how to use it? The important role plays the .xcompile file, which lies in the main coreboot root directory. It contains the paths to toolchain binaries as well as compilation flags, which are required in the build process. It is included in the makefile to set variables like CC, CFlags, CPP, object copy, object dump, etc. Let's look at more details in the code. How does it work? So, as we can see, the main makefile has the target for the .xcompile file, and it is produced by the util xcompile. It also leverages xgcc path. So let's see what are the usages of this variable. So here we see a check for the presence of xcompile file with wildcard, and if it does not exist, We just produce one with the util xcompile xcompile. Okay, so let's search for it in the utility. And here you can see. So basically, the util xcompile xcompile is a script that produces the .xcompile file, and it basically sets the variable based on the passed argument, or based on the search of basic directories. Like, there are some default directories where the cross toolchain may live in. This is util cross GCC xGCC. This is the path where the cross toolchain is actually built manually, or it may also reside in other like paths. It's libpyro cross GCC, other external cross GCC. When we have the coreboot SDK container, this toolchain lies in the root opt directory. So let's also have a quick look at the xcompile file. This is the xcompile file which is generated when we use the SDK, coreboot SDK. So we have basically all compilers for all supported architectures like ARM, ARM64, RISC-V. And here we have the compiler for the x86 64-bit architecture. As you can see, it sets all appropriate variables based on the config options. If we have libpyro compiler or GCC compiler or C-lang and stuff. Here is the 32-bit x86 architecture, which is the main compiler used for x86 platform for now, because coreboot doesn't yet fully support 64-bit architecture. And also we have some PowerPC 64 related definitions.